it's really hard to imagine how casually racist American society was in the 1920s. It was not unheard of to have lynchings of Italian immigrants or Mexicans or African Americans, even in a place like Colorado.
One of the great indicators of this growing xenophobia was D.W. Griffith's movie, The Birth of the Nation, probably the bestseller of its time, pitching a picture of these innocent white women in the South being haunted by blacks, glorifying the old South, denigrating black folks.
It showed white males dressed up in Klan uniforms, standing up for the white race against a threat. They were depicted as knights. They were on horses and they had lances.
And it really was a movie that was about the scourge of black folks in the country.
A Georgia businessman, a member of various fraternal lodges named William Joseph Simmons, revived the Ku Klux Klan. He created a social organization like the Rotary Club, except that it was based on Simmons' definition of 100% Americanism, white, native-born Protestant. And he created a hierarchy of recruiters. They called them Kleagles, who would go around the country and start local chapters, sell memberships to the Klan.
William Simmons shows up at the Brown Palace Hotel and in 1921 sets up a little group called the Denver Doers Club. And this evolves into what becomes the Klan.
The Ku Klux Klan comes to Denver and quickly spreads across the state with strongholds in Grand Junction and Canyon City.